Hi, this is Holly with Presence Point. Thanks for joining us for the third in a series on 2 Peter chapter 1. We've been talking a lot about how godly living is the result of cultivating the nature that God put in us when we offered Him our faith. And so as we talked last week and the week before, He gives us all we need when He gives us that nature to live a godly life. Sometimes we don't think He does, but He really does. But we have our part to play. We've got to be in His Word, we've got to be listening to the Holy Spirit and letting the Holy Spirit really work in us in that way. So we're this week in chapter 1. I'm going to read verse 5 and 6. For this very reason, make every effort to supplement your faith with virtue, and virtue with knowledge, and knowledge with self-control, and self-control with steadfastness, and steadfastness with godliness, and godliness with brotherly affection, and brotherly affection with love. Took us all the way through verse 7, actually. Last week, we talked about virtue, the fact that when we put our faith in Jesus, while our faith is growing, we now need to begin the excellence that comes with virtue, or the purpose, fulfilling the purpose for which God has called us and doing what we're meant to do. And then as that virtue is developed, we need to develop a practical knowledge, really a discernment, how to live life successfully. This week, we're going to talk about the next three characteristics that Peter mentions in verse 6. The first is self-control. Now, you know what self-control is. We know what it is. In fact, Paul speaks a lot about the importance of self-control and discipline when it comes to really winning the race as an athlete, right? He talks about it to the Corinthians, he talks about it to the Philippians, and even in his letter to Timothy, he reminds him of the importance of that. But if we even go back to the Old Testament, to Solomon, listen to the wisdom that Solomon gives us about self-control. Proverbs chapter 16, verse 32. Better to be patient than powerful. Better to have self-control than to conquer a city. Ooh, that's one I need to work on for sure. And then as we get over to Proverbs 25, verse 28, a person without self-control is like a city with broken down walls. If you think about that, in those times, the city walls fortified them, it protected them, it was safety. And what Solomon's saying here, it's much better to have self-control than even the protection against your enemies. The next characteristic that Peter lists in this verse is steadfastness, or really a patient endurance, especially when circumstances are difficult. Warren Wiersbe, one of my favorite Bible commentators, says this, "Self-control has to do with handling the pleasures of life, while patience relates primarily to the pressures and problems of life." We're all familiar with James 1, 2 through 4, but I'll read it anyway because I think it's important that we remember it. Again, James 1, 2 through 4. Dear brothers and sisters, when troubles of any kind come your way, consider it an opportunity for great joy. For you know that when your faith is tested, there's that faith that's growing that Peter talked about, right? Your endurance has a chance to grow. So let it grow, for when your endurance is fully developed, you'll be perfect and complete, needing nothing. Self-control, and then this steadfastness, this patient endurance. We have to have that patient endurance to really see the race to the end that the Father has for us here on this earth. And then the last characteristic we'll talk about today is godliness. And all that really means, like a literal translation, is God-likeness. And I think what's hard for me in that is I think I can't possibly be like God. I mean, it's not even surely possible. It's not even practical, is it? Well, I love this. In the original Greek, the word meant to worship well. To worship well. It described the man or woman who was right in his relationship with God and with others. It is practical. Godliness is possible because Peter's told us that God has given us the divine power for all things that pertain to life and specifically godliness. It's really about the person that makes decisions that are right and noble. The person that makes the hard decisions because it's the will of God or because he knows it's the right thing to do. It's a person who's concerned for the welfare of others, not just for themselves. And I think it's important to remember that it's somebody who really lives above the petty things in life. So as we finish this week, you think about those three things, self-control, patient endurance or steadfastness, and godliness. Take a moment, shepherd leader, shepherd mom, shepherd dad, shepherd pastor, shepherd supervisor, manager, CEO, shepherd board member, shepherd volunteer, shepherd friend. How are you doing with self-control? I know it spoke a lot to me, even in just preparing this video. How are you doing with patient endurance? Are you letting the trials work for you? And how are you doing with godliness? Worshiping our Savior well, making decisions that are right and noble, that are above all the pettiness that happens in our world. I hope you'll take time to make a couple notes about that, to think about it, to pray about it, to let the Holy Spirit work in you. And I pray that you will, in fact, this week, cultivate the godly life that the Father has given you the ability to live by reading His Word, by staying in Scripture, and by listening to the Holy Spirit. Thanks so much for joining us. May you live deeply into your calling this week. Take care.